Number one, you gotta win the point. If you don't win the point, it looks bad. Number two, if you do win the point, you gotta look over at your partner and see if he's as happy as you are. If you see the twinkle in his eyes, what do, Mike?
Then you take a decent length. You gotta run a little bit because you're not gonna get much air if you don't run. Never lead with the elbows. I've seen this happen one too many times where a guy leads with the elbow and just knocks the guy out. Get the racket out of the way. Come in with the chest. Get some decent height. You want to jump at the same height, right?
I always jump a little higher than Mike, but I'm taller. So does that work?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes.
We've only got injured like 4 or 5 times. It's a dangerous move, but we do it about 1,000 times a year. We get injured about once every 5 years. So the percentages are down. They're in our favor. You want to do it with someone your size. So if you're really short and you have someone coming in who's huge, not a smart play. You want to try to take girls out of it. Mike did a chest pump with a girl yesterday. Felt pretty good, but it's not a...
A little soft. You want to be glancing upwards. You don't want to come straight at each other. So, and then sticking the landing's big. You want to bounce off each other, fall back a couple feet, stick the landing.
Number one injury on a chest pump is a sprained ankle. Because if you hit too soft and come down straight, you're going to end up like that guy. And that's not cool.
Help me up.
You'd be on crutches.
And that is the chest bump. Let's give him one.
Yeah.